Hey everybody, what's up? Happy Sunday. I'm here at a recording studio. I'm going to be doing some English language dubbing. Here's some of the technical stuff. That's Philip, the main actor, the main character. He's a little cutie. But yeah, we got all this recording equipment. We got a studio. Just waiting for them to set up the booth. And yeah, it's going to be good. I've done a Japanese TV show before, but I've never done any Bulgarian film or entertainment, except for this inside joke between me and my friend Allegra. We pretended we were from Eid, Bulgaria. I don't think that exists, but anyway. All right, talk to you soon. Bye. Hey, Thomas, reverse shot.
What's up?
Runaway Smartphone. It almost sounded like a Bill and Ted movie, because it's like people travel back in time, people come through time.
Yeah.
So, we're just laying in some English dub. Dub life.
Dub life chose you.
Tom was cool to work with. Very easy. Don't work with him. And it's Aura Studios? Aura Sound?
Yep.
Soundworks?
Soundworks and Aura Studios.
Word. Check it out. It'll be coming out. Coming to America soon. Quite the sunny day we are having in sunny LA. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the shade. left the recording studio here on San Fernando Boulevard in Burbank. I'm really excited to put my mirror out. Drive safe. I'm not driving right now, by the way. I'm parked. Warming up the car. But yeah, I got to do some English dubbing voiceover work for this film called Smartphone Runaway. It's a Bulgarian film. Female writer. Go female filmmakers and female writers. Really cute film, really funny. Really cool sound engineer named Thomas. Hey, Thomas. Thank you for all your help. So, ooh! Fast motorcycles. LA motorcycles are so dangerous. If you don't believe me, watch my previous video.
I imagine this is a tough role mentally for an actor to play. How much did it help to have this great collaboration with Karen?
Oh, I mean, that's it. That's my rock. So when I go, are you sure this is gonna work? Can you see that this is? And she's like, yeah, no, I can see. And I mean, the amount of time
I wish you're blind,
but I trusted you. And I love the details. So we spent so long trying to find the right leather jacket, because that jacket had to be like, I live in it. It's got to be a part of my body. It's got to feel like. It had to feel right. I mean, how many fittings did we have just to get that leather jacket? And then, so that sort of detail is what I crave as an actor, what most actors crave is detail. And then slowly putting together her past from birth all the way through to the present, and trying to then say, well, how would that have affected my body, my face, my psyche, or every part of it. I mean, that was us together putting, because also the other thing is, it's rare as an actor that you get given the screen to think, to sit there and be allowed to think, to sit there and be allowed to just be. And that's a brave choice as a director to go, no, I'm gonna trust that I can hold on this, but it means you've got to have all of that percolating, and everything has to be real and vibrating and coming out.
Till I see myself.